Good evening, everybody, and welcome to another student talk session tonight. Tonight we are going to have our 8th session. It's really nice, and we are every week we are having very different students from different universities, and we have a chance to listen their ideas and suggestions and about their language adventure and what they think about language learning. So they're really wonderful, and their ideas are really precious. And tonight. And we are going to have again two different great students from different universities from Turkey. And one of our guests is Elif Arslan from Tokat Gazi Osmanpaşa University. And our other guest is Duru Tunç from MEF University. So let me invite them and then we can start our live session. Just going to invite them. Yes, I have invited both of them. When they are here, we are going to start. Yes, yes, Duru is here, Elif is here. They both are here. Hello, Duru and Elif.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, it's great to see you. And I would like to say thank you very much for accepting my invitation to student talks. And it's really great honor to have you here in student talks 8. Yes. Okay. Yeah. So, all right. So I'm sure that you are very excited like me, because I'm really excited to listen to you. And I'm really wondering what are you going to say about my questions. Okay. So I don't want to waste time. And I don't want to take your time, by the way. If you are ready, we can start. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Wonderful. All right. So let's start this question to both of you. Like, can you tell us about yourself, please, and a bit about your experiences in language learning? Duru, let's start with you.
Okay. Hi, my name is Duru. I'm from Izmir, and I study architecture in MEF University. I just finished my first year in university. About my English education, I can say that English was always included in my life since, like, in kindergarten. The school that I go for like 12 years was really valued English, so mm-hmm. they expected us to, you know, speak and understand fluently, and so I can say that English was always in my life.
I see. Okay, thank you very much. What about you, Elif?
Hi, I'm Elif. I'm 20. I'm student of English language and literature department in Tokat Gazi Osmanpaşa University. And for 12 years, I have learned English. Mm-hmm. And in 2014, I started philosophy in I started learning philosophy in English at the Science Center. And I prepared lots of English projects in there. I improved mm-hmm. my English also in high school thanks to my Dutch teacher. And after that, I improved my English also in university thanks to my foreign friends.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. That's it.
I see. Thank you very much to both of you. And the next question is, what was or were your turning point or points in your own education? Let's start with you, Elif, this time.
In second grade, I passed the Science and Arts Center's exam. It was the biggest turning point in my education life. Because thanks to the intelligence games that I learned, mm-hmm. I eliminated my distraction, and it was the biggest turning point for my education life.
I see. Okay, thank you very much. Yes, Duru, what about you?
I think my turning point was in the summer holiday between middle school and high school. I mm-hmm. started watching English series like so much every day. So it really helped me to improve my English, first of all, and it really encouraged me to English lessons. Mm-hmm. I can say that.
Okay, so that's your turning points. All right, yeah. So thank you very much to both of you about sharing your turning points in your own education. Okay, so let's move to some language part then. So this question to both of you, like, if you could have, what would have skipped or added in your English lessons? Yes, Duru, let's start with you.
I would definitely add some speaking sessions in English classes because I don't think there are enough opportunities in classrooms. So that causes we don't really comfortably speak in public or in classes. So I think this is really important to add some speaking sessions.
Some speaking sessions. Okay, thank you very much, Duru. Yes, Elif, what do you think about it?
Actually, I can say same things. I would definitely add more speaking lessons because a student who has been talking regular English lessons for 10 years still cannot speak English fluently. Mm-hmm. I think this is a very big shortcoming for our education life, and we can add more speaking lessons.
Yeah, same. Yeah, the both of you are the same, I think. Yeah, speaking lessons, you would like to have more in English lessons. Okay, thank you. Yes, next question is for you, Drew. So let's move to the next questions. Like, as teachers, and we are used to the term like washback effect, and we know that, you know, the washback effect as a testing can be both positive and negative. So I have a few questions, you know, about your assessment experiences in this case. Can you tell us about like a test that motivated you and made you study and learn more, and a test that caused just the opposite?
I remember there was this test in sixth grade, my first English exam of the semester, and my grade was like 95 out of 100, and it really motivated me to, you know, teach more English and for the other exam. So it was my one of the, you know, washback effect
for you about it. Okay, would you like to add anything else, or that's it?
No, that's it.
All right then. Okay, thank you, Duru. So let's move to the next question then. This question again is to the both of you. Like, you had, you know, the tens of exams or and quizzes in your English classes, and do you think that they were related to the real life? Like, if not, what kind of questions would you like to see in the exam? Let's start with you, Elif.
Okay. Of course, they were related to real life, but I would like it to be aimed at improving student skills, such as writing, listening, reading, and speaking. I want to see them more in the exams.
Mm-hmm. I see. You would like to see them more. What about you, Drew?
I think if I was in still high school, I would say no, they're not related to real life, the questions. But when I think back, it was actually really related to real life because, as I mentioned before, the school that I studied for 12 years, our exams were pretty comprehensive. So I think it was related to real life.
It was related to real life. Okay, thank you very much for your answers. Okay, Elif, next question is for you. This is really critical questions. What makes a teacher the best and the worst for you? This is really...
Yeah. I think an understanding, friendly, well-equipped teacher is the best for me. Because an sympathetic teacher cannot add anything to the student, no matter how well equipped he or she is. Firstly, he or she he could be understanding, friendly. After that, he or she could be well equipped, I think.
I see. Okay, so that's your idea about it. Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much, Elif. So let's move to another question. So, again, the next question is for both of you. Like, do you feel that you have learned how to read and listen in terms of language skills? Yes, let's start with you, Duru.
I think so, actually, because we both, as I understand, we both have been studying English. So I think we learned how to read and listen. And I think watching English series really helped me to listen and understand English.
Watching English series, it helps in this case to you to improve your reading and the listening skills. I see. Okay. What about you, Elif?
I agree to her. I think I learned how to read and listen, but not completely. I have to improve myself about that.
I understand. Also, so you have the same idea, like Drew. Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you. Let's move to the next question. Could you find enough opportunities to practice speaking in the class and outside the classroom? Yes, Duru, let's start with you again.
Like I said before, I don't think there are enough opportunities in classroom to speak comfortably. But personally, I had, and I also still have some opportunities to speak in English. For example, for my friends, foreigner friends, foreigner relatives, with them, I can speak with them.
You have opportunities to speak outside the classroom, which is really good for you. And so you're lucky about it. Okay, thank you. What about you, Elif? What do you think about it?
I did not have the opportunities to practice in classrooms. But I think I have improved myself thanks to my friends. When I got a talk out, I met lots of Africans. And my ex-boyfriend was African, especially thanks to him.
Nice.
I improved my English.
I see. It's good. Thank you. Thank you very much. So also you had the chance to speak, you know, the English outside the classrooms too.
Wonderful. Yeah, it was
so
very
lucky
chance
about
for me.
It. It's a great, great. Okay, so let's move to the next question. Do you think you have learned how to learn? So, for example, after all those years with English lessons, and now you have it, so can you start learning another foreign language on your own? Yes, Elif, let's start with you.
I don't guess I learned to learn completely. I can't learn a language by myself. I might need an instructor to start learning a new language. But I think I knew that very well, how to improve myself. I can improve myself, but I can't learn any English by myself.
I see.
English
okay.
or the other language.
English or the other language. I understand. Okay, yeah. Thank you, Elif. What about you, Duru?
Actually, I think I can learn another language by myself because, I don't know, since we have some applications on the phone, which we can, you know, learn any language we want. I think so.
I think so. Okay, you can learn with the help of the applications, as you said. Yeah, there are many applications in, you know, the mobile phones or the internet. There are lots of things that we can learn it. I see. Okay, thank you very much, both of you, about answering this, the questions which is related with the language learning. So let's move to another questions again here. This question is again to both of you. Like, can you tell us 5 phrasal verbs that you always use in and outside the classes? Yes, Elif.
Be over.
Be over. Okay.
Come on.
Okay, 2.
Feeling.
Okay, 3. 2 more.
Get back.
Get
back. Go back. Bring about.
Okay, thank you very much. Nice phrasal verbs. Thank you, Elif. Good. Yes, Duru, what about you?
Come on. Break down. Maybe come up.
Okay.
Bring up.
Bring up, good. And one more?
One more. I don't know.
Yeah, you can think about it, maybe.
Maybe I can say.
Come on, you can say one more. Okay, 4 is enough. Thank you. No problem. 4 is enough. Okay, not a problem. Let's move to the next question. So, I really wonder what are you going to say about the next questions. Like, if you could have one superpower to use in the classroom, what would it be and how would it help? Yes, Elif, let's start with you.
It's so hard. Maybe I have a hard time understanding accents while learning a language. I want to know all the accents in a language. It can be useful for our listening exams.
Oh, I see. Okay, you want the kind of ability that understand every kind of accent in the language.
Yeah, because it's hard to understand different accents.
And it's, I see.
Yeah.
Okay. What about you, Duru?
What I can be your superpower? I actually agree with her because I think understanding different accents is very hard.
So also you want to have kind of a superpower to understand the accent of the people. Okay. So, all right. If you say that, not a problem. All right. So let's move to the next question. What was the biggest challenge that you have faced this year so far, Duru?
I mentioned before, past year was my first year in university, so I moved a complete different city by myself. I started a new life, which is a student life. I started to live in a university dorm. It was pretty difficult for me, and it wasn't a really good experience for me, actually. I can say living in a dorm.
Living in a dorm. Okay, I understand. So what about you, Elif?
Me too. This year I faced many difficulties as I just started university. First of all, it was difficult to move a new city, to make new friends. And also my exams were very difficult for me because I did not know how to study. And these are so hard for me.
Yeah, that were the, the challenges that you face. Okay, thank you very much to both of you. Okay, so next question is, can you tell us five adjectives that describe an effective language learners? Yes, Elif.
Talkative.
Talkative, okay.
Original, creative.
Okay, creative.
Intelligent.
Intelligent, and the last one?
Hardworking, of course.
All right, wonderful. Thank you, Elif. Yes, Duru, what about you?
I don't think I can find any other five, but I can say patience.
Patience, good.
Maybe hardworking also, she said.
Hardworking.
Maybe. I don't know any other one.
Okay, not a problem. Okay, you said just patient and hardworking. Okay. Great. Thank you very much for your, the ideas about it. Let's move to the next question. By the way, just two questions left, you know, before the last questions. Time flies. Oh, cool. Really? Okay. Let's think that we finish the interview and you step outside the house and find a lottery ticket that ends up with winning $10 million. What would you do, Duru?
I really don't know, but I would probably buy a house, not in Turkey, probably in another country.
No, in another country, not in Turkey. Yes. Okay.
I would spend it for my education, maybe for my family. I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Okay, it's a nice dreams about it. I hope you find the 10 lottery tickets with the winning $10 million. Yes, Elif, what about you?
Firstly, I was spending on my education because I went to study in English-speaking countries. After that, I would use it to help to stray animals. Oh. And the others, I would spend invest for my future, probably.
Your future, probably. I see. Okay, thank you very much. So let's move to the last question. So here is the last question. What is your motto, Elif?
What's my motto? Actually, I have two motto for my life. The first one, don't worry about anything. The second one is, never give up. If you want so much, there is nothing you can't achieve.
I see. Okay, great. Yes, Duru, what about you?
Work, but don't forget to have fun.
Okay, work, but don't forget have fun. Okay, nice one. All right, great. Nice mottos from both of you. Thank you very much. Okay, so that's all my questions about it. So before ending our live sessions, would you like to add anything else, Elif?
No.
No, okay. What about you, Drew?
I also don't have any, but thank you for your invitation.
Yeah,
it was pretty fun for me.
Okay, it's also fun for us also. Okay, thank you. Okay, again, one more time, I would like to say thank you to both of you for, you know, the being with us. It was really great and fruitful session with both of you. Thank you very much for spending your time here at this time with us. And Duru and Elif were with us tonight with student talks, and we had a really great time with them. And I'm sure that you also enjoyed listening to them here, like me. And next week, we are going to be here with two different students from two different universities. And until next time, which is Monday, every Monday, like student talks at 9 p.m. Until next time, wherever you are, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. And until the next time, take care of yourselves and take care of yourself, you too. And again, one more time, thank you very much. And peace, everybody. And peace. Bye-bye.
Thanks for everything. Bye.
You're welcome. Bye.